Previously on MasterChef Australia.
You're cooking in the classic MasterChef time auction, Murray River style.
It was a battle of the highest bidders.
I'm going to start off at 20 minutes.
Let's just go straight to 40. Oh.
40 minutes.
Oh, yeah. Why would you do that?
Please don't send him to a house auction.
Well, let's go.
Time.
Come on.
And pantry items were not on their side.
This is madness.
But
it was unbelievable.
Gold standard. Mental. It is absolutely perfect.
Theo triumphed with a winning dish.
Congratulations. Come Thursday, you'll be cooking for your spot in finals week.
Yay!
Tonight, the top five travels continue. Somewhere totally unexpected.
You're kidding me.
Wow.
Oh, my God.
This is so random.
What the hell?
Oh, look at the flowers.
Wow, we are in cactus country. There is cactus everywhere.
Really? It's like a bit euphoric.
There's so many different varieties too, isn't it? Feels like we're in Mexico, right?
Yes.
The road trip really has taken us to Mexico. I can't believe it. I didn't expect this in regional Victoria, but here we are.
Hola.
Beautiful cactus country. And, you know, it's the last spot for someone to get into that immunity cook, and I feel like there's some prickly tension in the air.
Ah. Wow. Oh, everyone got their hats on. We're in cactus country.
Hola. You're all looking very sharp this morning. Welcome to Cactus Country.
Yeah.
You are standing in the largest cactus garden in the Southern Hemisphere.
Wait, what?
Yeah. Right here in Strathmerton in Victoria's Murray region.
Who would have known?
This incredible 12-acre garden is home to over 4,000 species of cacti from all over the world.
4,000?
Declan, Kath, one of you will join these gentlemen in tomorrow's immunity challenge. Unfortunately, Rhiannon isn't feeling well today, so she won't be joining us, which sadly also means she's out of running for the immunity challenge tomorrow. Declan, what does this place evoke for you?
Look, I'm not that familiar with the old cacti, but I know like some subspecies, maybe aloe and agave. I use aloe vera a bit after, you know, having a bit too much sun. And, of course, tequila. I've had a couple of cheeky tequila shots in my life, so I'm familiar with it in that sense.
Brent, you've travelled around the world. Are you getting any inspiration from this environment, what you see right now?
The only thing I've learned this morning is not to touch them, so my fingers are stinging, but...
How old are you?
Yeah, I know.
It took you that long to realise.
You look at something that's...
They're just so, biting.
Like you were that kid
growing up. Yeah, I was that kid, yeah.
Well, to the challenge at hand, eh? We want you to cook us a dish that takes us straight from the Murray to Mexico.
Yeah.
We couldn't take you. We'll just get you to cook it.
Yeah.
Oh, this doesn't really play to my strengths, Mexican food. And I know Declan loves Mexican food. He cooks it a lot, so it's going to be a challenge for me today.
You will have 60 minutes to bring us a Mexican-inspired dish.
Amazing.
The pantry is full of fresh local produce and Mexican flavours. It has everything you need to bring us a dish that is a fiesta, not a siesta.
Good.
Yeah.
Well,
that's it, man.
Yeah.
Good luck. Your time starts now.
Hello, guys. How are you back?
I'm gonna beat you.
You're gonna get ingredients or equipment?
I'm gonna get equipment first.
All right.
I'm gonna go up this way.
Yeah, you go.
All right.
It's right up my alley today, especially that we're outside. We're cooking in the great outdoors.
Okay.
And I absolutely love Mexican food.
All right, Tomatino.
It's something I cook with my girlfriend on a weekly basis, so I have so many ideas.
Let's get these going to start with.
When I think Mexican, straight away I'm thinking margaritas and what goes well with margaritas. Tacos.
Keeping it traditional, so I'd like to do grilled flathead taco with a tarimada, which is like a Mexican charred salsa. Gonna have some fresh coriander and the white onion for that fresh hit, a bit of charred corn. Gonna try and do two different types of tortillas.
With this dish today, there's those taco holders there, and I'd love to have one yellow corn tortilla followed by a blue corn tortilla.
I think it's just gonna look beautiful on the plate. And yeah, that's sort of what I'm trying to do, make my food look a bit prettier as well as taste amazing.
Are you mixing them, Decky?
No, I'm just might do two different coloured ones.
Now that I'm inside the top five, I think my eyes are on the prize.
Bit ambitious, but I think I can do it.
And if I want any chance at taking out Kat...
Red onions. Red onions.
Everything has to be up to that standard, restaurant-worthy and spot-on.
Ah, there you go. Alrighty.
Octopus.
Okay. Mexican is something I'm not familiar with or comfortable with, but I know like the basic sort of flavours, so I just want to try and just keep it simple for me.
So today I'm going to be cooking Mexican octopus with a salsa and avocado cream.
Brent's not cooking today, so I'm just going to rub it in and I'm going to cook octopus on the hibachi.
I've cooked octopus before, but I haven't cooked octopus on the hibachi, so I'm actually excited about that. So I've got all these Mexican spices. So my plan is to add some oil and make it into like a little rub. I've got some cumin, some paprika, some oregano. I'm going to go really simple Mexican flavours.
Just oil.
I need to simmer the octopus for 45 minutes before I kiss it with the smoke on the hibachi.
Unfortunately, the water's taken a long time to boil, so I'm a little bit concerned about it actually cooking in time, but we'll just see how we go. I might just take a little bit out. That did a lot.
Okay. So that'll boil in a sec now.
Yeah,
you did that.
Yeah, I'm sure. Yeah. I'm sure it will. Okay.
You've still got some in there. Stop touching all the cacti.
Here we are in cactus country, and I mean, just look at it. It's completely transportive. We feel like we could be in Mexico, so you know, we're hoping for a little bit of that beautiful vibe today. What would you cook if you were in this?
I think, I would go super traditional. I'd have to cook tacos because when you go to Mexico, it is what you remember.
Mm.
You remember the tortilla.
Yeah.
You remember the salsas.
Yeah.
The proteins, like, for me, it's not really about that.
Look, I would be with Andy. I'd be going for tacos. Salsas and
yeah.
Spices and flavours and aromas and
yeah.
Loads of fresh herbs. Do you know what I mean? That's it.
There are so many different flavours all playing beautifully together. It's exciting food.
Oh, like those tomatillos up on that hot
eye. Yeah, I don't want to say.
Lean on here.
I've got my dough resting to the side for my corn tortillas, and now I'm going to move on to charring my corn and capsicums for my tarimada. I'll be bashing it all up in a mortar and pestle to give it that fresh, spicy, vibrant salsa feel.
Right on time, Declan.
Right on time.
What's happening?
Not much.
What do you got for us?
So I've got a bit, but I'm trying to keep it traditional.
Yep.
I'm doing a flathead, grilled flathead taco.
Mm-hmm.
With a tarimada,
yep.
So traditional sort of Mexican charred salsa.
Yep, love it.
I'm going to be doing like a fresh sort of cilantro and the white onion.
Yep, beautiful.
And I've got my tortillas over here that are just resting, ready to go in the press. So I think it's going to come down to the perfect tortilla.
You got two types.
Yeah. And I think it'd just look beautiful having different colours, so two of each.
Is it worth it?
As I'm talking about what I'm going to be making to the judges, I realise I'm definitely overcomplicating it.
We all know how that ends.
Nah, keep it simple, stupid.
All right, buddy.
All right.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Yeah.
So, making a couple of adjustments, I'm just going to focus on doing one kind of tortilla and really just, you know, make it punchy and vibrant and give it that Mexican twist that they're after. You all right, Kath?
I'm just trying to get this water boiled and it's taking its time.
My octopus is not even in the water yet. It needs about 45 minutes to braise before I can finish it off on the hibachi.
Come on, water.
You have 45 minutes till fiesta. Come on!
All right, guys.
If I don't cook the octopus long enough, it's just going to be rubbery. It's just not going to be palatable.
Come on, come on.
I have to make a decision right now. Am I going to risk it or am I going to pivot and change? Only 45 minutes left in the cook and my octopus is not even in the water yet.
Come on, water.
I have to make a decision right now. Am I going to pivot and change my dish already?
All right, let's just quickly. The water's not even boiled.
I really don't think it's going to work with the octopus.
Just come through, buddy.
Yeah, you're all right.
I'm going to have to think quickly now.
What do you got?
Oh, I've got some chicken wings.
All right. You're all right, Kath. Let's do it.
Spewing. I really wanted to use that octopus.
I've decided to go with chicken wing because they're really quick to cook. So plan is now just to do the same thing with the chicken that I was going to do with the octopus. So I'm not going to let it worry me. I'm just going to go and we'll just go with the chicken.
Love wings.
Love wings.
Love wings.
That's my spot.
There's flies. I'm just getting rid of them for you.
I appreciate it.
All right, we're halfway through, guys. Only 30 minutes to go. Come on.
Flies, here they are.
Time is flying by, and I really need to start pulling this dish together, cooking off the tortillas, cook my fish, and finish off this tatemata. You know, you really want to get your back into it. I want them to have a generous size to them, so, you know, the fish and all that beautiful tatemata and freshness sits in there. I'm pretty happy with how the tortillas are looking. Flip it, they're looking good. They have a nice char on them.
That's warming up.
And yeah, I think it's just all gonna come down to the cook on the fish and how it looks on the plate.
How good's it been in Mexico?
Mexico's great, isn't it?
Take us to Mexico in 5 minutes!
Yeah. Whee! On, Kath.
I feel like I've made the right decision to pivot with the chicken because I have all the ingredients aside for my salsa.
Yeah, it smells nice. I'm just going to see how they are.
And chicken wings are ready to go on the hibachi and I can smell those aromats, which is really lovely.
Oh, chilli.
It's quite spicy, so I'm hoping the avocado cream cuts through that spiciness.
Right, yeah, it's just a kisser.
The cat who originally came into this MasterChef kitchen would not have been able to do that. Even think about a different concept of cooking octopus and then having to pivot to chicken. I've developed. I'm always developing.
1 minute to go. Come on.
Come on, let's go. Let's go. Push.
I think I've definitely hit the Mexican brief today, keeping it traditional with tortillas and grilled fish. But I think the standout on my plate today is that tatemata. At this point in the competition, presentation takes a huge part. So I'm trying to piece this together so it looks beautiful.
30 seconds!
Come on, Kath, come on.
Push.
Let's go, come on!
Come on, let's go!
Well done, you two.
Beautiful. Good job.
The first dish we'd like to taste belongs to Declan.
Beautiful.
Declan, what'd you make?
Today I've done grilled flathead tortillas with a tatemata and a fresh coriander, onion, charred corn.
It looks very nice. These flies are nasty, huh?
I'll do you. You wait.
Can I get involved?
Declan, this guy here, this salsa, that is where it's at. That mixture of the char from the tomatillos and the onions and the soaked dried chilies with a good whack of lime juice, that's where it's at, mate. Like, yeah. Honestly,
awesome.
Done it really, really well. And it's your take on it, you know? And then being as pared back and really just having the confidence to put raw onion, charred corn, and a little bit of coriander chopped up. These two things today is the most transportive and what I wanted to see out of this challenge, right there.
I really thought there was a lot of mastery in how you've pulled together your side hustles because they're both contrasting in flavours and textures, so they gift the entire dish complexity, texture.
Declan, good job on the tortillas. Really, really nice. And the fish, perfectly cooked.
Well done, Declan.
Thank you, Declan.
Thank you.
Awesome. Awesome, Declan.
Righto, there's only one thing left to do.
Go, Cat.
I'm really nervous taking my dish up to the judges. My biggest concern is, am I taking these guys to Mexico today? Have I hit that brief?
What did you make for us today?
I've made some Mexican chicken wings with a salsa and an avocado cream.
Wonderful.
Kath, I think you did a decent effort. I could tell that Mexican cuisine isn't like your go-to.
Yeah.
Probably eating or cooking, am I right?
Yeah, you're right.
It kind of shows here on the dish. The chicken wings themselves, they're tasty, they're delicious. You've coated them in your signature Mexican spice mix. Thinking you could have made this better by maybe rolling them in smoky chipotle number after that, I think that would have sent them to a full nother level. The two sidekicks, they're good. They're not, like, blowing me away.
True Mexican is something that needs practice, investigation,
yeah.
Research,
yeah.
And it's not something you can pull out the bag if you just don't know it. And that's okay. We don't.
Yeah,
we
sure.
All don't know everything about cuisine.
Mm.
That's the wonderful thing about the world of food. It's now opened a door for you, and if you choose to investigate it, you will go down this wormhole of flavour, and it is absolutely amazing.
Okay, thank
Thanks,
you.
Thanks, Kat.
In this tasting, it came down to the dish that took us all the way to Mexico. And that was you, Declan.
Aww.
Congratulations, mate.
Getting this spot in an immunity cook gets me one step closer to a spot in finals week, so it feels pretty awesome.
Three amigos, hey?
And I'm ready to go home and have a taco and kick the feet up.
So, we have our cooks for tomorrow's huge final immunity challenge. But we also have a huge surprise for you.
Oh, yeah, of course.
Going to Mexico. Oh!
The three of you, Declan, Brent, Theo, you're going to cook for an all-important advantage in tomorrow's challenge. Right now. Oh! Surprise!
Oh! Still got it, don't we?
Hang it on!
Look, I was knocking off. I was going to have a nice cold beer after a hot day in a cactus field. And, yeah, well, now I've got to somehow gather the strength to cook.
So, this is a surprise advantage round, and we want you to cook with a surprising ingredient. Well, probably not so surprising given where we are. Of course, I'm talking about cactus.
Yeah! Yes! All right.
Yeah, look, to say it's going to be a prickly challenge is probably correct. I don't think any of the boys have cooked too much with cactus, so it's a pretty level playing field today.
Brent, Theo, Declan, you can cook whatever you like, but you must use cactus in your dish. We're giving you 60 minutes and a fully stocked cactus-friendly pantry. And the top dish in this round will win a game-changing advantage in tomorrow's immunity challenge. Don't take this lightly.
Okay.
This advantage could be the reason why one of you becomes our first contestant into finals week. A lot to play for, lads. Good luck. 60 minutes starts now.
Oh, he's off track.
Oh, that's so tight.
Let's go, fellas.
I've never cooked with cactus, but I'm always trying to do better than my last cook and go one step ahead.
Round two for me today. Oh, I'm stoked that I've made it into the second round and a bit scary that we got to cook with cactus, but I know prickly pear and I know it's sweet, it's tangy, and I'm sticking today with the Mexican roots. And I'm going Mexican rice with a steamed fish, that tatemada salsa again, and I'll be reducing this prickly pear glaze down that will be going over my fish.
It's all about cacti today. So I'm using prickly pear. I'll chuck some agave syrup, which is made from cacti, and I'm familiar with that. And then some prickly pear blood orange liqueur that I found in the pantry.
It tastes a bit like Campari. It's prickly pear and bitter orange, so I think that would make a nice Negroni. Yeah. On a day like today, I could go for that. Did you grab some of those dried chilies, fellas?
I did, mate. I've got some here, so
if
you need some, come
and grab
some.
To share those.
Yeah. I'm cooking pork tacos today with a prickly pear glaze. I'm going to pressure cook some pork, and then I'm going to cook it on the hibachi after that to get some char on it. I'm using Berkshire pork belly today from the area. I want that to come out and still have that texture to it so that I can glaze that pork with a very sticky glaze. I've got the prickly pear and the agave syrup in the glaze, so I'm hoping that is enough for the judges. At this point in the competition, hitting the brief is really important. Prickly pears does taste sweet, but it is quite mild, so I'm hoping I can enhance the flavour with a lot of Mexican spices.
Oof, it's hot.
Hey, Brent, how are you, mate?
Yeah, good, mate. What do you want me to do?
All right, just peel some garlic for me, if you have a chance.
Yeah, I'd love to.
You've had 15 minutes. You've only got 45 minutes to go. Come on.
Yeah.
Brent.
Good day.
What's going on, mate?
Oh, mate, just a bit
surprised?
Very surprised, actually.
Yeah, I heard you say I had clocked off for the day. What are you going to do?
So I'm doing a twice-cooked chicken in the pressure cooker.
Yep.
And then I'm going to fry it, and then I'm going to hibachi some cucumbers. Yeah, as for the cactus, I'm going to make a sort of a sweet and sour glaze for the chicken at the end with the agave and prickly pear.
It sounds like a good dish.
Yeah.
Good luck.
What I'm thinking is I know cactus is quite soft, the glaze will be sticky, but that's why I've gone with the crispy twice-cooked chicken. I want that crunch. I want the glaze to just stick to that crispiness.
I want a sort of sweet and sour glaze, so I think, you know, I can sweeten them up with agave syrup and then with some vinegar.
I love the colour.
It's good, isn't it?
It's amazing.
I've eaten prickly pear and I know that they're not bursting with flavour. And I can hear that there's a few cactus glazes going on next to me. I'm picking that up. To win today, it's going to be about the brief. It's going to be that you put enough cactus in there to really feature it. I need to stand out. And I know that glaze is not going to be enough. I've got to come up really quick with plan B.
My sweet and sour glaze is, you know, lacking in flavour.
Now think how to inject more cactus so that when they eat it, they actually think of cactus. I'm just tasting every single cactus there is, and I'm trying to think what I can, you know, imagine it becoming, or what other ingredient kind of tastes like, where I could sort of pretend I'm cooking with that ingredient, because I haven't used these. And then if I'm tasting the strawberry cactus, and kind of reminds me of little pomegranate seeds that you put in a beautiful salad. So I'm thinking I'm gonna make the strawberry cactus ulcer. Really, those strawberry cactus are gonna do absolute wonders in the little salsa for like a textural pop. So across the board, there's a lot of cactus going into this dish. Hopefully, when I get to the end of it, it all screams cactus.
Rentals, can I take some of that agave?
Yeah, bro.
Careful. What are you doing?
And hopefully, all those needles aren't in the dish and they're just in my hands.
I've got bloody prickly pears in me.
Look sharp, 30 minutes to go.
Come on, gentlemen.
Let's go.
Any friend?
Right, buddy?
Yeah, I'm good.
You weren't lying about those flies, were you?
Jeez.
30 minutes to go. I've got my glaze on. It's starting to reduce. My pork is getting pressure cooker.
That's good.
So I move on to my corn tortillas.
Man, it is hot.
All right, now I'm in my happy place. I feel like, you know, this is going to come together really nicely. You know, a beautiful pork belly that with that prickly pear, your sticky glaze and your beautiful corn tortilla and a little salsa on top. It's going to be a really nice bite of food.
Theo.
Theo.
Hey, guys.
What's happening?
Loving the flies?
Loving it. What's happening? What are you cooking?
I'm cooking pork belly. I've got it in the pressure cooker with a bunch of chilies, and then I'm going to take it out and I'm going to glaze it with this prickly pear glaze.
What's that here?
Prickly pear juice and agave, bit of chicken stock, a bit of cumin and a bit of coriander.
Have you tried that?
Yeah, I have.
Tastes like? Not much.
Not much.
You need to turbocharge that, man.
Yeah. Today we have to use cactus in our dish, and the judges want to be able to taste that cactus flavour, and I don't think I'm hitting the brief.
We know what the advantage is for tomorrow. You want it.
Okay.
Trust me.
All right.
Every advantage right now, it is gold.
Sweet as. Thanks,
come
guys.
On.
Cheers. I'm sort of spinning right now, and they're telling me that, you know, there's not much cactus there in my glaze, so I need to turbocharge this. Just a bit of a worry that it needs some, you know, something more. It just tastes like prickly pear and chicken stock. I've really got to think today. I've got to think on my feet. And I will take any sort of advantage over these two cooks because they're great cooks. I've just amped it up with a few more aromats, a few chilies. I've just got to make sure that it's got all the flavour in there that I want.
face is bubbling away. Shut up. Fish time.
I'm feeling good. My Mexican rice is on the go. My prickly pear reduction simmering away. Now I need to get started on this fish.
Alright. It's a big bloody fish.
This time I'm going to be doing a steam fish, and kingfish is a thicker, more versatile white flesh fish.
And that's going to steam perfectly with some Mexican aromats.
I'm massaging this glaze into my kingfish and they're going beautiful, pink and vibrant. It's tasting so nice and sweet.
Mmm, yummy.
And I'm thinking maybe I can incorporate this prickly pear reduction into my tatemata.
Yeah. All right, the cactus is going in that.
Yeah. Tasting beautiful. It's balanced out and there is that sweet element in there. I think I'm onto something new here.
Oh, I like it.
And I'm trying to stick to this Mexican vibe. I see there's corn husks there, so why not steam my fish in the corn husks?
My steaming basket's ready to go.
I'm just going to treat it as cooking it, you know, in my baking paper and foil.
Nice deck lamp. Oh, look at that.
So the chicken's out of the pressure cooker. It's going straight into the deep fry. It's now time to get that chicken stock into a nice big pan, start reducing that. It is quite a sauce and full of flavour. The more it reduces, the better it's going to get. And as I'm tasting the prickly pear glaze, it's now just screaming sweet and sour. I think I'm onto a winner here. The chicken, you know, it's going to be super crunchy, and then this sticky, reduced glaze painted over the top of it.
Feel like I'm at the beach.
And then comes the smokiness with the cucumbers, putting them on the bottom underneath the chicken, and this beautiful, you know, dark, rich sauce. Cucumbers are just going to suck that up. The sweetness in the glaze, acidity in the strawberry cactus salsa. Yeah, I think the guys should just pack up and go have a beer while I finish this dish off.
Not going to play down. Huge advantage on the line for tomorrow, and you have 10 minutes to go.
Come on, 10 minutes. Come on, finish it off. Come on, friend. Go, Theo.
10 minutes to go. I am pushing. I've got to finish my pork on the bocce. I've got to do a quick salsa as well, so I've got a lot to do. I'm happy with the cook on the pork. Now I need to make sure that the glaze is just where it needs to be so I can hit it with some heat from the barge. But I'm looking at my glaze, man, and it's just not there at all.
It's ridiculous.
This is meant to be my cactus element. I needed this to really reduce, but looks more like a stock now. I'm worried that I might have to kiss goodbye to that advantage. Come on. I needed my glaze to get to that sticky stage, but it hasn't reduced enough. But I'm running out of time and I've got to use it, so I've got to hope that it still permeates that prickly pear flavour.
This is my baby.
It's crunch time now. It's all got to come together on the plate and look bloody beautiful. So I check my fish and it's beautiful and flaky. Of course, I'm thinking about presentation in this round and at this end of the competition.
Gorgeous, Dick.
So I grab a cookie cutter and I'm placing my rice in that so I can demold it.
This is what I live for.
Oh, it's beautiful.
As well as my tatemata in a beautiful jug and my steamed fish wrapped up in that corn husk. Looking at my dish, I think this advantage could be mine today. It looks bang on, and I hope I've hit the brief.
1 minute to go, come on!
Yeah, the last minute is absolutely frantic. I haven't even started plating up. I'm trying to get the glaze on the chicken. You know, if I don't get that on there, then all the work gone into that glaze is just thrown out the window. I've got to get the sauce in the little jug. I'm just pouring it all over the sink, all over my hand.
Oh, oh sugar. No. Oh.
Brent.
But what I envisioned at the start of the cook is what's on the plate right now. I'll tell you what, I'll be a wounded little soldier if I don't get the win today.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
That's it.
Good job, fellas.
Good job, mate.
Just lost 30 kilos.
Yeah.
Needed it.
Good job, mate.
What a great surprise, eh? We threw a cactus challenge at you. Okay. Obviously, the winner of that will get an advantage in tomorrow's immunity challenge. Which, believe you me, you want. The first dish we'd like to taste belongs to Declan. Let's go, Sam.
Come on, Declan.
Looking at my dish today, I definitely think I've got a shot at this advantage. It looks bang on, and I hope the judges love it.
Declan.
Hey.
What have you cooked?
I've stuck with the Mexican vibe. I've done steamed kingfish with Mexican rice.
Yep.
And a prickly pear tatemada.
Where have you featured the cactus?
So I've featured my cactus in the tatemada. I made the glaze and rolled the fish in it before I steamed it, and I've got the agave, the prickly pear, and that cactus bitter.
Declan, picking up a lot of good Mexican vibes, right, in terms of flavour. You gave us absolutely perfect fish, permeated with that sort of corn husk flavour and the prickly pear glaze.
Loved the presentation. It came up and I was like, that is exactly what I was looking forward to. There's definitely some technique stuff there. Tatemada really did kind of add to the dish with the sweetness of the prickly pear. And you really nailed it both in round one and round two, so good stuff.
I hope that you can be so proud of yourself thinking about your journey through the competition, because day one, Declan would not have ever conceived of this. And look at what you're doing. It's really beautiful stuff.
Thank you.
Thanks, Declan.
Next up is Theo.
Yes, Theo.
What have you made for us today?
I have made prickly pear glazed pork tacos.
Is there enough prickly pear in this dish to suffice the challenge?
Look, I hope there is. I hope that the prickly pear is in there and it has a nice flavour to it.
In the sauce only?
Yeah.
Nowhere else?
Nowhere else. It's in the sauce. It's agave syrup as well. That's where I went with it.
Okay.
Good job on the tortillas. Nice flexibility, they're not cracking. Very good. But I don't taste the cactus. And whether or not that's a twofold thing here, how can you expect the flavour of the prickly pear juice to be more than the chilli?
Yeah.
Which is a shame, because that could have been brilliant, because you set it up magic with the perfectly cooked piece of pork. I wanted it so much to be glazy and sticky and cactusy. Do you know what I mean? And it would have been perfect. You were so close, mate. Just execution, Theo.
Yeah.
Prickly pears, man, they're like, on the flavour scale, they're a 0.5 out of 10. So it was also a bit of a trip hazard for everyone out there today. Thanks, mate.
See you.
Thank you.
Brent, let's go, mate.
I think overall, the dish looks good. Tasted everything together besides the chicken, and, you know, it tasted really yummy. I could taste cactus in there.
Come on, get after it.
Drown it.
Hopefully it's enough to hit the brief and I get the win.
Brent, what's the dish, mate?
Today you've got twice-cooked chicken, prickly pear glaze, then there's strawberry cactus salsa.
Gotcha.
Nice amount of heat in those chilies.
Brent, I'll start with the sauce. Love the sauce. Like, you know, you're getting stronger and stronger in your sauce section. Every cook that you are, whether you're in the kitchen or out in the elements, big tick there. And of all of the glazes that we've had today, yours was the tastiest. Out of the use of a cactus in the dish, yours was probably the best. The salsa was delicious. Like, I really love the use of that, the little strawberry cactus in there.
The salsa had a really lovely dimension of flavour. The heat, the savoury qualities of the coriander and the onion, and then the little pops of the strawberry cactus, I thought was a really smart way to use it. And that's what we were talking about earlier, is you may not have used these ingredients before, and we certainly don't expect you to, but try it. Get the idea of what the qualities are of it, and then find something familiar in your repertoire to integrate that into. And I think you did that really, really well.
Yeah, thank you.
The funny thing about that fruit is there isn't a huge amount of flavour. There's more aroma than flavour. And of course, we can taste more with aroma. So when you're eating it, as you're eating it, you're getting the aroma.
Yeah.
And that's the bet. That, for me, the brief was filled.
Awesome.
Thanks, mate.
Awesome, thank you. Mate.
Here in the largest cactus garden in the Southern Hemisphere, we wanted you to bring us the captivating cactus dish.
Declan, love the concept of your dish, but Brent, your dish, it featured cactus in the way that we're looking for, which is why, Brent, congratulations, you got the advantage.
Thank you.
It feels really good to go into immunity cook-off at the best of times. God. But to go in with a really big advantage is everything right now.
Get ready to battle it out for the very first spot in finals week year three. We'll see you all tomorrow for that last location on our road trip. And trust me, it's a big one.
Big one. Okay.
Get out of here.
Bye.
Tomorrow night on MasterChef Australia.
Holy dooly.
Wow.
I've never seen anything like it.
It's a phenomenal finish for the top five road trip.
It's all been leading up to this.
With the final immunity cook and a service challenge all rolled into one.
There's never a dull moment.
It's going to be very, very tough.
Oh, my God. I am going like a one-armed bricklayer.
It's an ending of epic proportions.